Nature's fury unleashed like never before. In 1991, the world watched in awe as Mount Pinatubo, located in the Philippines, erupted with a force equivalent to 10,000 atomic bombs. The volcanic eruption spewed ash and rock over 20 miles into the sky, creating a cloud that reached 22 miles and impacted the global climate for years. The eruption's aftermath caused massive damage to the surrounding areas, resulting in a death toll of over 800 and leaving thousands homeless. It was a stark reminder of the destructive power that Mother Nature can wield. And now, scientists are warning us again about something significant. Should we be scared? Let's go into the details to understand. The underside of the Tonga volcano, which erupted in such a spectacular manner in January, has been described as having been hit by a gigantic magma hammer by scientists. An examination of seismic waves has uncovered four separate occurrences, each of which is understood to represent a thrust of molten rock occurring beneath the underwater mountain. The findings were made public in a study that was presented at the American Geophysical Unit conference that took place in Chicago and was written by Larry Paxton, a researcher who works at the Applied Physics Laboratory at Johns Hopkins University in Laurel, Maryland. Which were covered by Joel Achenbach of the Washington Post, the point at which one is considered to have entered the realm of space is commonly agreed to be 62 miles above the surface of the Earth. The eruption in Tonga was so powerful that satellite readings suggested water was propelled to a height of 150 kilometers, 93 miles above the surface of the globe. The volcanic eruption not only ejected water into space, but it also caused tsunamis that spread across the world's oceans, completely reversed a west-to-east current high above Earth in our planet's ionosphere, 50 to 400 miles above Earth, and produced an amount of energy that is believed to be equivalent to the most powerful hydrogen bomb that has ever been detonated. This information is according to a report that was published in the Post by Achenbach. A year ago, while Larry Paxton was observing the boundary between space and Earth, he observed something that he shouldn't have. Paxton makes use of devices that are mounted on satellites and looks down on the region of space that lies immediately above the atmosphere. They are able to monitor unusual space weather and other phenomena by seeing in light spectrums that we are unable to, such as the far ultraviolet. By the end of January, his team noticed something strange while scanning the area. A portion of the map had become opaque. The rays of far ultraviolet light were being taken in by molecules of some kind, resulting in a dark blotch that was approximately the size of the state of Montana. As time went on, it became abundantly evident that the Hunga Tonga volcano in the South Pacific was the origin of the ash cloud. These molecules, which Paxton's group eventually calculated to be enough water to fill 100 Olympic swimming pools, had been propelled into the air at a speed greater than the speed of sound by an explosion that was unlike anything that had ever been documented anywhere on Earth. Paxton, who presented his results at the American Geophysical Union a few weeks ago, states that this is an enormous amount of water to get injected that high. This is a truly remarkable occurrence. If I see an absorber, if I see that hole, that means that something got above the boundary to space and sucked up those photons that would normally get sent to my sensor, explained Dr. Larry Paxton, who works in the Applied Physics Lab at Johns Hopkins University. That crater was the size of Montana, Germany, or Japan, someone said. 1 year later, scientists investigating practically every aspect of the Earth, from the mantle to the oceans to the ionosphere, have had moments remarkably similar to Paxton's, in which they have been astonished by some exceptional discovery caused by the Hunga eruption. In the most recent few months, scientists have witnessed the largest concentration of lightning ever recorded, as well as new vibrational waves that have ricocheted across the globe, which has resulted in tsunamis being triggered in ocean basins that are far away. According to Holger Vommel, a scientist at the National Center for Atmospheric Research, the freshly discovered water molecules represented the very top of a gigantic plume that filled the high atmosphere with sufficient water to trap heat underneath. This will likely result in a little warming of the Earth over the next several years. The explosion that occurred on January 15, 2022, was definitely quite weird. However, academics are now wondering just how exceptional was it. The response could have repercussions for the dozens of submerged volcanoes that are found throughout the world's oceans. The Hunga eruption highlights a new type of volcano and new types of underwater threats, says Shane Cronin, a volcanologist at the University of Auckland. The Hunga eruption highlights a new type of volcano and new types of underwater threats. Despite this, there have been just a few undersea volcanoes that have been the subject of in-depth scientific study. These include the axial seamount, which can be found a couple of thousand miles off the coast of Oregon and has been the subject of research since the 1970s, as well as the long-active Kikemjenny volcano, which can be found close to the island of Grenada in the Caribbean. Both locations are continuously monitored by sensors that listen for rumbles and receive frequent visits by research cruises. However, a significant number are located in inaccessible regions of the Pacific Ocean, a great distance from major urban centers or ports where research vessels find safe haven. Their nearest neighbors are small island states like Tonga, which do not have specific volcano monitoring programs or a lot of resources to deploy seismic monitors. They are particularly vulnerable to natural disasters. This is owing, in part, to the challenges posed by geography. Tonga, for instance, is made up of a string of islands, which makes it difficult to triangulate the locations of the sources of seismic waves. Additionally, manpower and financial resources can be limited in countries with populations that are comparable in size to that of a big U.S. town. There are international options, such as the U.S. Geological Survey's Seismic Monitoring Network, that offer global coverage for unusual geologic activity. However, the stations are generally too few and far between to pick up the softer rumbles that foretell a coming undersea eruption. According to Jake Lowenstern, director of the Volcano Disaster Assistance Program at the USGS, there are international options, such as the U.S. Geological Survey's Seismic Monitoring Network, that offer global coverage. The majority of the eruptions do not stand a possibility of being as explosive as the one that was caused by Hunga Tonga. However, the experience awoke people throughout the world to the possibility of volcanic activity at these locations, according to Sharon Walker, an oceanographer working at the Pacific Marine Environment Laboratory. She is quoted as saying, "While incidents such as this do not take place very frequently, my impression is that we do not want them to take place on our watch. It is very obvious that Hunga featured a recipe that was unusually explosive and may not have been simple to recreate. The volcanic eruption had been proceeding as forecast for the past month and a half. It was somewhat intense, with gas and ash, but it was still manageable. Then, everything began to spiral out of control." According to Cronin, this seems to be the outcome of the interaction of at least two different elements. One of these was the combining of multiple sources of magma, which was subterranean and had somewhat varying chemical compositions. As a result of the interaction between them, gases were created, which expanded the volume of magma that was contained within the constraints of the rock. The enormous pressure caused the rocks above to begin to break, which in turn allowed the icy seawater to begin to seep in. According to Cronin, the seawater added the extra spice, if you like. As a result of the tremendous explosion, which actually consisted of two separate events, trillions of tons of material were propelled directly out of the top of the caldera, with some of it apparently making its way all the way into space. Both of those explosions caused significant waves in the ocean. Cronin believes that the water flowing into the hole that was quickly dug out of the seafloor at a depth of 1 kilometer could have been the cause of the largest wave that occurred afterward. He says, "That's something really new to us," referring to a different kind of danger that needs to be considered elsewhere. In the past, researchers believed that the only way a volcano of this type could actually cause a significant tsunami was if one of the sides of a crater fell. According to him, the takeaway from all of this is that underwater volcanoes are more varied and in some circumstances more capable of exhibiting extreme behavior than anyone previously believed. But the process of putting together the pieces of the eruption has also brought to light the difficulties associated with investigating undersea volcanoes. In a typical mapping expedition, a large vessel with a complete crew will be utilized. This vessel will be outfitted with multi-beam sonar, which will map the bottom in search of changes, as well as a battery of water sample gear, which will search for chemical evidence of ongoing activity. But crossing a potentially active caldera in a boat is dangerous, not so much due to the possibility that the volcano would erupt as it is due to the possibility that the rising gas bubbles will cause the ship to capsize. Researchers in Tonga were able to tackle that challenge by employing a combination of smaller ships and autonomous vessels. Even Tonga, which has been visited 4 times in the past year because of an influx of research funds to organizations investigating the eruption, is not expected to have another major crewed mission in the next few years, according to Cronin. This is because of the financing that has been provided to the groups who are studying the eruption. The price is really quite steep. Even if we limited ourselves to the volcanoes in the Tongan arc, it is likely that it would take decades to complete a comprehensive assessment of all of them. According to Walker, it is unfortunate that such excursions will no longer be possible because they are one of the only methods by which scientists can get close enough to truly witness how volcanoes are behaving. An ideal situation would include additional financing for those missions, in addition to investments in upgrading new technology, such as autonomous vessels, which can be difficult to operate in the dangerous open ocean. This would be the case in the ideal scenario. Without them, scientists can only stand idly by and observe from a distance. When attempting to witness activities taking place underwater, this is a challenging task, but it is not impossible. The use of satellite technology makes it possible to detect phenomena known as pumice rafts, which are sheets of buoyant volcanic rock that bob on the surface of the sea. Satellite technology can also detect algae blooms, which are nourished by the minerals released by the volcanoes. In addition, the United States Geological Survey, USGS, and its counterparts in Australia are in the process of constructing a network of sensors around Tonga that will improve their ability to detect volcanic activity. These sensors will combine seismic stations, sound sensors, and webcams that watch for active eruptions. According to Lowenstern, ensuring that it continues to be operational will be a challenge. This will involve ensuring that the systems remain connected to data and power sources, as well as ensuring that Tonga can adequately staff the facilities. He goes on to say that Tonga is only one of many countries in the Pacific that could benefit from receiving assistance. However, it is a beginning. Researchers have now found new volcanic features to keep an eye out for as a result of their in-depth study of the Hunga volcano, which is one of the benefits of this line of research. Cronin envisions a process that will take place over the course of the next few years to determine which volcanoes demand more attention. Cronin's crew made use of the time aboard the ship during their final Hunga expedition in 2022 to visit two more submerged volcanoes in the sea. One of these volcanoes is located around 100 miles north of Hunga and has a mesa-like topology, which is similar to the topography of Hunga prior to its eruption. The maps will serve as a baseline for any future surveys that are successful in getting out on the ocean. This will provide researchers with a method of determining how much activity is taking place beneath the sea and the rock. According to Cronin's last report, the ocean appears to be calm. That's all for the video today. We will be right back. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.